Welcome to the journey. This is episode 3, the moment you've been all waiting for. We're gonna put it all together. Neely's even gonna try it, right?
Absolutely. We're gonna have our cake and eat it too.
And we're gonna learn about some social media marketing tips that they can apply. My favorite platform I wanna dive into, Instagram and Instagram stories specifically.
Just take their business to a whole nother level.
Next
level. Just like those layers on the cake.
Don't wait for it.
A whole nother level.
Look at the peaks on that. And now we're gonna dive into episode 3 where we're gonna get more into marketing and websites, but we might as well cut the cake, right?
Let's cut the cake. Let's let the professional.
Yeah, yeah.
We've done enough.
I'm done.
To that. But see?
Look at your buttercream.
Oh yeah.
That you did amazing. A good job.
Great job.
We get it. Neely has more of the talent in the kitchen. We'll get it.
I think we'll hire him.
There you go. This is delicious. I'm sorry you can't have any. They'll be selling soon, I hope.
Well, if you help us with our website and our social media, mm-hmm. we're well on our way.
Speaking of that.
One of the things that we thought would get started, use a website as an opportunity to bring people in and do pop-up events. So pop up some of the notifications on our website so we can start to like generate the interest and get the community to come in, taste our cake.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then we thought we'd do like a taste test too.
Yes.
Test the market, like do people
Neely
like
Neely will do that.
I know, yeah.
I'm already doing it. This is a winner.
We also want to use a website as a journal because right now we don't have any cakes to sell.
Mm-hmm.
But to follow us through the journey of what it takes to get us to that launch product.
Mm-hmm.
So that people feel that they're part of the community that we're trying to build for this cake.
Mm-hmm.
Part of what's behind our name that we had chose, All Purpose Co. Co does not only just stand for company, but it stands for community, collaboration, and
community.
I love it. One thing that you probably want to start doing now once you get the website going is have somewhere to collect email addresses. Email is the easiest way to really connect with your followers on an ongoing basis. And tell them about the pop-up events.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Ongoing and ongoing. And just
that's
another way
idea.
To tell your story.
Yeah.
So you have a new blog post out, share that with your followers via email.
Yeah.
Because the algorithm changes, especially on Instagram. Not everyone's going to see your post. Email, they'll always see it.
Oh,
gotcha.
Okay, yeah, I like that. So if you can give us some advice for navigation through the website, because I've seen some websites where all the tabs are on the top, some are on the side.
Yep.
What I like is where it's laid out like a table of contents, like a cookbook.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Like, what's your advice? What's the best way to approach this?
Yeah, I think it comes down to what do you do when you visit a website? Like, look at where your eyes go. Are there certain things you click on? Is there certain colors that really pop?
Mm-hmm.
But there's a pretty standard methodology of literally the Z flow. I don't know the proper term, but I'm going with the Z flow. So you go left to right. On the screen, down, and then left to right again. It's just
gotcha.
The way we read. So the most important content needs to be on either that top right section or that bottom right section.
Right.
Whatever that call to action that you want them to do, maybe it's to check you out on Instagram, maybe it's to check out your newsletter, whatever that looks like, have right there. Because that's gonna be the most important content, and then tell them what to do.
Gotcha.
Right? Don't let them guess, right? I know my brain span is probably a goldfish. I'm everywhere just squirreling out. Tell me exactly what to do. So get your daily dose, get your daily dose of emails to your newsletter or whatever that looks like. Tell me right there.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
I know Emma's probably itching to
talk
on Instagram.
Let's get over there. Let's pull it up. One thing I love that you guys are doing is that on a lot of your posts, you're not only mentioning other businesses. So let's go to this one, for example.
Mm-hmm.
We used eggs from these guys today.
Mm-hmm.
And you actually, in this, mention the Sisters Farm.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I would just ask right away is, do you know if they have an Instagram?
No,
they don't.
Well, we should tell your friends.
Yes.
So I love the hashtags that you're using, farm to table, hashtag fresh, hashtag all-purpose cake co, hashtag keto. Mm-hmm. And that's really great because it's going to help you to be found mm-hmm. by really your target audience, yep. for yes. one, or other businesses out there, maybe a coffee shop that is yes. looking to get this on their menu. Mm-hmm. But one thing I noticed when I've been following you, which it's been briefly, but is Instagram stories is something I saw you leverage today. But I'd love to see you guys leverage it more okay. because majority of Instagram users, like, they're spending time on stories mm-hmm. every day. Yes. And then when you're actually on there, for example, you did a boomerang today,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Yeah, did it right here. One thing that you can do, you know that on your stories, similar to some of your posts, you can mention other businesses. Did you know that?
Oh, no.
Yeah, so think about, where are we right now? We're at?
Yes.
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 Whose kitchen?
Lay's.
Awesome. Lay yeah. is on Instagram.
That's right.
She has like right. 450 followers.
She does.
So you yeah. mention Lay and your story.
Okay.
You can even tag the location of yes. where we're at, yes. the city, mm-hmm. and even add some of those hashtags, keto or all purpose, and then anyone searching okay. for, let's say, hashtag keto or mm-hmm. whatever we're baking that day, they could come across your story.
Okay.
And
okay.
you might get a new follower.
Okay, so same as a photo
yeah.
post, but on story.
Yeah, okay. and then think about okay. too, we say we mentioned Lay, yeah. maybe mention GoDaddy,
that's
and
right.
then you know what happens? They get notified on their Instagram mm-hmm. and then they go to it, GoDaddy if you mention them, mm-hmm. Lay, and then you have more of a chance maybe they repurpose your post because it's one click for them.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm just thinking now the other big part is user generated content mm-hmm. and you want to get more of that, and okay. stories is a great way to do that. So while it's tempting to like take that boomerang and just put it up there, you want to make sure you leverage as much as you can.
Okay.
Tag places, mention other businesses. Okay.
Yeah. I guess we're learning, and I guess the stories is definitely a great yeah. advice to add mm-hmm. that in. And I have a 16-year-old, and I think she, I do
has
recognize,
helped
has helped a lot.
Yep.
So she taught us some of her tricks and how she generates her own. It's not just about throwing pictures out there, it's participating with everyone else.
Yeah,
looking through their content.
Yeah,
you have to be engaged. And I'm like, yeah, like I love what other people are putting in.
For sure.
You know,
sure.
and I should be liking because I like what I see.
Mm-hmm. Some of my favorite bakeries that I follow are the ones that do Instagram stories because I, while I love to just eat the dessert, I enjoy it even more knowing how did this come together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's a local, she does like marshmallow type bakery items, and what she does once every week, she does an Instagram live video.
Okay.
Of her
the whole process.
Okay. Huh.
So what Instagram does and Facebook too is when someone goes live, it notifies all
yes,
of their followers.
I noticed that.
Oh,
I noticed that.
And how long
yeah.
is that live? Is that live content saved, and other people can now see it as a recorded?
Yep, it'll pop up in their story. It'll have a different circle around your little photo.
Okay.
And then they can watch it for 24 hours. You can download that video if you want to use it for other okay. content and
nice.
Break it up and piece it up.
Okay.
Yeah, you can almost make it like, do you remember like way back the day before Netflix and Hulu, uh-huh. like shows would come on at Sunday at 8 o'clock. You
yeah,
had to be there
yeah.
for Sunday at
yes,
8 o'clock.
Yeah.
You could potentially do something like that to where your followers now expect you.
Yeah.
Like, oh wow, it's 2 o'clock on a Thursday. They're
yeah.
on, I have to watch this.
Another thing you do in your bio up here uh-huh. is put your favorite hashtags that you think are gonna be the most successful, like your all-purpose baking co. Add that here because this
okay.
is where I see, you know, I check you out, I get a little bio on
gotcha.
Both of you, and then I see, oh, they have these like hashtag or two that they clearly want us to use.
Okay.
So now when I'm at one of the local coffee shops getting my coffee and I have one of their delicious cakes
yeah.
and I'm mentioning you, I know, oh, that hashtag in their bio, I should use that clearly because
okay.
you have it there
yeah.
in your bio.
Yeah.
And then you
yeah.
get more content from your fans
okay.
and your customers that you can then repurpose.
I see.
Because you're juggling, you're doing a million other things,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So
crowdsourcing again.
There
yeah.
you go.
Yeah. Bingo.
Let them do the work.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Get some time back.
This is all amazing stuff.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much for teaching us how to make this cake.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to probably try it later at home and see how I do. We'll see. I'll at least get the buttercream right.
Yes, for sure.
Definitely.
And we'll try you
and tie
again.
Absolutely.
I'll stick to cooking.
Well, if you like this video, make sure you give it a like. Comment below on something you learned or if you want to check out this cake.
Yeah.
This is the journey. We'll see you next time.